Someone's
knacking up,
we were coming.
of goth, Roger.
I'm a goth. I've got to be labelled goth. I haven't got the thing saying goth over there.
He's left it, isn't he?
Bless him. Oh, yeah.
I'm good on TV.
For the ITV news.
Bang, is it?
Yeah.
Yeah, I've got a good telly, though. I've got a good
telly. What night is
going to be on the news? Yeah.
On the news?
What night is going to be on the news?
No.
Tattoos or anything?
Yeah, go for it.
Oh, no.
Where are you? Well, hang on, where are they?
How's your dragon?
You'll flash that lot.
Oh, God. Well, every other end.
There you go, you never go.
Where'd you have my lighter, boy?
Do you say a dragon?
This battery down here.
Jeez.
It's probably for channel 4.
I suppose that's the end of the world,
eh? Super job!
Hi guys, I'm Blue Movies. Oh my god.
Yes, Chapelfield Gardens, in sunny Norwich, on a lovely sunny day. Isn't it good? Right, fine, that's enough of me.
already shot the band. We're gonna do some more shots of the band later.
Well, go on then, act like goths.
How do we act like goths?
Do that, do this game.
Do what?
That's too much. Act like a vegan.
There you go.
Act like what?
Oh, you missed your trousers, Tom.
Oh.
I'm sorry.
Do it again.
Good one, action shot.
Yeah, that would be good. That's the spontaneity in your movie.
That's one hell of a spider.
He's rather.
Come on.
No,
it
wait,
works on animal magic.
There he goes.
Oh. Yeah, he's a wasp.
Well, go on, pick one up.
Pick one up?
Yeah, and put it on the spider. Onto the web. No, you have to pick it up.
Oh, no. I hate creepy crawlies.
Yeah, don't blame you, actually. But not too far away from the spider. I'll do. Excellent.
Oh, what? He's covering it.
Yeah.
I ought to give it the wasp, really. That might put more of a fight.
It's incredible, isn't it?
It is, rather. I don't know, the wasp must be thrown away. Oh, here it is. I'm going to get that. Come here. I'm not going to pick it up. Not that stupid.
feel quite a few vehicles on the road.
I don't know whether that has already passed the time. And the meeting of Cottesloe Royal British Legion Women's Section on Wednesday afternoon is off. The Maisie Kit swimming classes.
Slimming.
What's this swimming here?
Well, she takes slimming, so I don't think she takes swimming, so I'm guessing.
No classes today or tomorrow. The WI at Old Hunstanton is off on Thursday. Bingo tonight. The Happy Circle of Russell Street in Norwich is off, and so is the Day Centre, Wyndham and, I can't believe that, and so Wyndham Methodist Church Hall, Wednesday and Friday, they're all off. Keep Fit classes at Marlingford Village Hall are off tonight. Help for anyone who wants shopping in the Southtown area of Yarmouth has come through. This is Stephen Webber on Great Yarmouth 658060. In the Southtown area of Yarmouth, contact Stephen Webber on Great Yarmouth 658060. Thank you to all of you who are offering help.
I understand through in the other studio, I'm just waiting to talk to Nick Gardner, who's looking after things in there, that we may well be able to go over to the police. Nick is just telling me now, can we do it, Nick? Yes, we can. Right, so let's go and see what's happening at Police HQ. I think Nick Gardner's got some news from there, or at least Steve Hardy has. Steve?
Yes, David, it's me. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can, yes.
Okay, I'm joined in from down here at the police headquarters control room. Inspector Carl Stone, who's been trying to sort out the situation along with the police in the cab this morning. Right, Carl, it's Stirling Hobson. What is the situation on the roads in Norfolk at the moment?
The situation, quite simply, is this, that weather conditions are very bad, as probably anyone can see who looks out the window, and they're consistently and steadily getting worse.
What is your advice to people? Are you advising them to stay at home and not to come out?
My advice is quite simple. If you must make a journey, then make sure that you and your vehicle are adequately prepared. We've got a large number of problems with vehicles which are broken down and have been abandoned. And I think if you can possibly avoid it, don't use the roads at all today. Stay at home.
Now, we understand, in fact, some major roads are passable with care, but even they can get chopped up, can't they?
This is very true, because it only needs a large vehicle, or indeed a small vehicle, to suffer a minor misfunction of any kind, and it's stopped, it's a hazard, it's an obstruction in the carriageway, and we're all going to have more problems getting it out and getting the road gritted and cleared again.
What about minor roads out in the villages?
Minor roads in the villages, as far as we're concerned, are completely closed. Don't use it, don't try and get out at all. Stay at home in the warm and the dry.
There is going to be a problem tonight, isn't it? Because some people are going to have to try and get home and manage to struggle into work this morning.
It is going to be a problem later in the day, and I would advise anyone who has employees at work to seriously consider sending them home as early as possible, please.
Now, if you just look slightly ahead, the weathermen say it may drift later. In fact, it's drifting already on some roads, and that it's going to be another minus 12 tonight, with the temperatures dropping. So what's your advice to people for tomorrow about coming into work?
Again, unless you have to come into work, and I'm talking now about people really who are in essential services, I see no point in making the effort at all, because all you're going to do is add to the confusion of the chaos.
Thanks very much, Carl Stone. Back to you in the studio, David.
Thank you very much, Steve. A bleak picture. We'll keep you posted on BBC Radio Norfolk. Streets. Don't wear anything white, because you will eventually become invisible, unless you get run over by a snowplow. And don't forget, if you are going to be wandering around, take it nice and careful, make sure you've got some good stout boots on, and as tight that don't slip around, as Dave Brown found to his backside sort of pain last night. Thank you very much to the taxi driver who eventually took me out, because I wasn't going to risk it. Watched in this morning from just around the corner from Echo Street, just around the corner from Radio Bolton. Nice to know that the roads were nice and quiet, so it seems like everybody is heeding the warnings from the police and the motoring organisations to keep the car in the garage, keep it off the roads for a couple of days until they get those things sorted out. So, around about an hour's time from now. Nick's afternoon show this afternoon, well, we're going to be finding out how cheap whale fares. I'm going to hopefully help you out if you take your teddy bear with you. I still mind out of the toy box. And staying with trains, we'll be finding out more about the famous Orient Express and your chance to travel on it when it comes to Norwich soon. News in that all Eastern Counties National Express coaches from Lowestoft, Great Yarmouth and Norwich, which are scheduled for today, they have been suspended in the afternoon. They are both cancelled. And the Friends of Norcade High School in Durham, their committee meeting, which was due for tomorrow night, that has also been cancelled. That is another one of those victims of the weather. Don't forget, any more information, as soon as we get it, we'll give you all the information you need. And if you have any information, I know we've given you the number loads and loads of times, but it is important, of course, you do get it relayed so that lots of people don't go out and make that wasted journey in that freezing weather. Just give us a call now, 630 621.